Welcome everyone to today's chapel. We will be continuing our series on judging others. Now we are going to finish our acronym on the word judge. Today's letter is E. E stands for everyone has a different background. In the Bible, the parable of the Good Samaritan shows us if we judge others because of their backgrounds, we could hurt them even more than they already are. Point 5 is, when we judge others, we are comparing ourselves to them. What are we really doing when we judge others? We are comparing ourselves to them, such as our staff, our reputation, our looks, and our identity. We are trying to convince ourselves that we are better than them, and we actually think we deserve more. And anytime we want to be better than everyone else, anytime we think that we deserve better than anyone else, what are we doing? You and I are saying that, I am the man, I am the woman. The truth is, there really is only one I am, and that is God. He's the only one who can judge, but he is the only one who is perfect. He is the only one who can purely judge without any evil intentions and hidden agendas. God doesn't love one person more than the other. He doesn't love me more than he loves you. So just like Jesus told the religious people, you without sin throw the first stone. You shouldn't judge people because they don't have what you have, don't make the same grades you do, and don't like the same things you like. But show them the love of God by not condemning them or making fun of them, but just hanging out with them and getting to know them.
You've been judged by someone? How did it make you feel to be judged by that person?
Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for everything you've done for us. Lord, I just pray that you help us to not judge others this week and to be nice to everyone. I just pray that you help us finish this year strong. In your name I pray, amen.
Hey, Jillian, can you teach me how to underhand serve?
Yeah, okay. So you go on the hip, you hold it, and then you gotta throw this, and you go. Oh, dang.
I think you might have asked the wrong person to teach how to do that. You should have asked Leah before. It's actually her birthday. Happy birthday, Leah!
Hey guys, it's Haley and Hannah. So good to see you again. Ms. Marshall invited us to talk about the high school worship team and why you should try out for it. In our experience, we've had a good time in the worship team and making those relationships with each other and growing in the Word. And even if you're scared to do it, or if you're really scared that people are gonna make fun of you or you can't sing well enough or whatever,
been people on the team who have that experience.
Yeah.
And it's okay.
Yeah. I mean, we really accept anyone. It's just getting out of your comfort zone to really share the gospel and try to influence your fellow classmates for the Lord. And it really does pay off in the end, and you won't regret it. So I hope you try out this year, and I wish you luck.
Woo!
Bye.
Bye.
That rage inside, though the shadows steal the